Did you know it apparently takes 3 months and 11 days to feel better after a breakup? But according to Charlotte from Sex and the City, it's more like half the length of your relationship. Meaning, if things end after 4 years, then it takes 2 years for you to get over your ex.
So in your case, 4 years.
That's long.
What do you think, Pika? Why do you think Annie broke up with me? Annie Ko Su Lin, Breaker of Hearts, I Hate You. The only way to deal with this is to be logical, says Professor Pika. You are a researcher. Find out why she left you. Thanks, Prof. You miss her too, don't you?
Do you have to?
It's for research.
He's processing.
Seriously?
Annie did it over the phone.
That's harsh.
She couldn't face him. Just cut him off cold turkey.
Okay, rolling. We can treat this like a conversation. Let's just keep this natural. Why did Annie break up with Joel? Actually, can you give a bit of background first on how you know them?
Yeah. So Annie and I were in the same Sociology 101 tutorial in NUS, and at that time, she had just started hooking up with Joel. And oh my God, we were all so envious of how in love they were. Didn't you end up moving into her room at the hostel?
She moved into my room because it was quiet.
Yeah, so you guys could make noise. Oh my God, you guys were at it like rabbits.
What do you expect? They were in love.
Annie and Joel were inseparable. You couldn't imagine one without the other.
Yeah, I've known them for the past 3 years when I first started going out with Nat. And when I first met them, I was like, whoa, hashtag couple goals. They were just so solid.
Fast forward a few years, it was like
watching a car crash in slow mo.
This is my analysis. Joel didn't give Annie what she needed, so Annie was ready to move on. Their differences in love languages led to a communication breakdown, and Annie's emotional needs were not met, especially when she lost her job and when her grandmother died. Joel was just so self-involved and insensitive.
Babe, he is in pain.
So was she. You can't sugarcoat these things. Love hurts. Joel, Annie wanted to get married. You knew that. She was hoping you'd propose at our wedding. And you guys look so good as best man and bridesmaid. Why didn't you? Didn't I drop enough hints?
The whole marriage thing was on the cards. Just not so soon.
Water.
Thanks.
Need me to move?
No, that's good.
How's this? How are you?
There are good days and bad days, I suppose. More bad than good recently. Thanks for doing the interview.
That's fine. You're like a little brother to me. It's kind of cute that you're doing this. You know, I miss having you around. But it's been nice seeing Annie happy again.
She's happy?
She's taken up dragon boat racing and even drumming lessons.
Is she seeing?
No, she's not dating anyone. Yet. Look, it wasn't easy for her. She cried for days, you know. But now it's like a weight has lifted off her shoulders.
I didn't know I was such a burden.
Have you got a hypothesis?
What?
You said you're doing some research. Don't you need a hypothesis?
I'm still gathering my materials.
Okay. Tell me, why do you think Annie broke up with you?
Our friends say that...
No, it's not about what your friends say. What do you think? What were some of the problems that you faced as a couple?
Well, I don't know. I thought we were doing okay.
Look, if you can't even answer that question, then clearly Annie made the right decision breaking up with you. It's over, Joel. Move on.
Hey, handsome.
Auntie, one Milo pink, please.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
Nah. Hey, where's your girlfriend?
We broke up.
Huh? Why, huh? Better lah. No point staying together if you're not happy, right? She always looks so sad.
Auntie, is it okay if I film you and ask you some questions?
Huh?
I'm researching why she broke up with me.
Huh? I don't wanna. Ayah, this is all fate. You both are not meant to be. Cannot force one, huh?
Sorry, I was at a meeting.
Well, what's for dinner?
I thought you were cooking.
You invite me over and ask me to cook.
Mom, I'm not in the right frame of mind right now.
Well, nothing a good meal can't fix. Expired.
Instant noodles expire?
May 2018.
Are you sure?
Don't you have any rice or pasta? Joel, you need to look after yourself better. Throw away. Ayo, what do you cook with?
There's still some left.
What else have you got?
Thank you.
Oh dear. How are you feeling?
A little all over the place. Lost. Angry. Restless.
Just give it some time.
That's a cliche I've heard a lot.
Well, it must be true then.
Why do you think Annie broke up with me?
I know it's awful to hear this, but you're just not what she wants anymore, Joel.
I really thought we were okay.
Is okay good enough?
We were fine. She changed. I didn't.
Could that be the problem? You're still the same guy from university she fell in love with.
Well, what's wrong with that? He's quite a cool dude. I thought we were in this thing together. And she suddenly decides she wants out. It's not fair.
Relationships don't work like that. Annie has different needs now, and maybe so do you. The truth is, you stop growing together, so you grew apart. Yes, sorry, another cliche. I blame it on the beer.
I never understood that one.
Well, love is sneaky that way. Drifting apart happens slowly, over time. Sometimes you don't even realize you're moving further and further away from each other. The two of you are at different phases in your lives. She's ready for the next chapter and you're stuck at page one.
Page one.
You'll figure it out in your next relationship.
Buen appetito, signora. Gently charred and very crispy. It's the house special.
Joel, this looks awful.
Sorry, we don't have anything else.
Maybe you're not ready for that next relationship yet. Let's order some food. My treat.
Annie Kosulin, you were always the cooler and wiser one, always ahead of me in so many ways. I wanted to think that you were wrong this time, but again, I'm the one playing catch up. I'm coming around to your decision, that we will both be better people without each other. Thank you. Sorry. And goodbye. Dear Professor Pika, as you are aware, research is never straightforward. It has taken me down different paths and made me face some ugly truths. But I'm getting there. Some clarity is in sight. I hope you will grant me an extension.